college game.
I don't think there's any amount of money that I'd want to do that for. That's pretty crazy.
I don't know, man. You get a blowjob and money.
From a dude.
How much money?
Kevin's on the right track, Tim.
So there's a price tag. You guys have an amount.
Always a price tag,
nah,
Tim.
I don't know, dude. It's not that I'm homophobic, but that's not bad.
What if someone was like, we will give your children $1 billion each?
Oh, for my kids?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I take a shot.
Oh, she's weird. Yeah.
For my kids? Yeah.
That's so dumb.
Yeah. Not
for like, myself. A little bit of horror.
It's called
a
sacrifice,
lifetime
Shane.
Of
look it up.
Yeah, but if somebody said the same thing to you and said, we'll give you $1 billion. Oh, no. Now your kids get $500 million each because you could just give it to them.
I didn't think of it that way.
You're an idiot.
Well, it's just something I never considered, you know, as an option of giving it to my children. Yeah.
Well, why wouldn't there be? It's your money.
I don't know.
Kevin, what's your price? My guess is Kevin's price is somewhere around $75.
$60.
Oh, come on. If I was going to do it, I would at least make it so I could get a computer.
<You know? laughs> As long as you give me a new computer.
Yeah. New computer with all the fixings, baby, and then I'm in.
Yeah, why does Kevin have like a lisp today?
I think it's just the idea of him haggling for a f***ing computer. No, I gotta have a better sound card than that. That's not gonna work for me.
I won't take
listen,
that crappy
sir.
Buick.
Listen, sir, I need another 20 on top of that.
I said curved monitor.
Yeah.
Just see you.
That's not 8K, sir. I want 8K.
Curved monitors are great.
I just got your guys' text.
I just sent another one. I'm not going to be able to make it, guys.
Her son's sick, but yeah, she wants to get some pictures of us like in like urban settings to give it like a album feel.
I think then we have to probably go to either downtown Vancouver or Portland.
That's what she wants to do. There's some sites in downtown Vancouver.
Downtown Vancouver's perfect.
Yeah,
Portland would be awesome.
Fuck that. I'm not going to Portland. I'm not leaving my car
in
Portland.
We should do a gender reveal for you down there.
No. We're not doing anything.
You dress as a pinata, and me and Kevin get to hit you until either pink or blue pops out of you. What do you think, Kevin? I think that sounds fucking awesome.
That place, man. I hate that place.
We'd probably have a bunch of fucking BLM and Antifa
dude,
join
it in. Would be so great. It would be like, dude, this guy's white and angry at you people.
What do you mean, you people?
And then I get beaten
then
to death.
Then everybody just jumps
yeah,
in.
Yeah, we just all get beaten to death down there.
That might form some unity down there, actually.
I'm going to second downtown
enemy.
Vancouver.
I think it'd be hilarious. Let's go to Portland. Well, I'll bring the Hummer.
Downtown Vancouver's getting pretty gross, too. But
yeah, but it's not nearly as bad as Portland.
Yeah, so eventually that's what she wants to do with us. She wants to take us out standing up.
Maybe we should figure out a day.
Dude, we can even have a more fun version. Let's go to Seattle. Go to the old record stores. Sub Pop?
No, that video game place.
Which one's that?
The giant fucking arcade in Seattle.
There's a I didn't know.
Yeah, it's like three stories.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Yeah, it's cool as shit.
I'd just be playing Mortal Kombat then making Kevin play Mortal Kombat with me house.
I haven't been there in decades. We're starting the show, but
It's been recorded.
Okay, well, I was going to say, because they got this. When I went there decades ago, literally decades ago, there was a game where you sit in a chair, and it goes up and down the three stories, and you're like in a hot air balloon or something. You have to dodge balloons. So you're steering yourself up and down.
That's weird.
Fucking awesome game.
That sounds really weird.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Like I said, it's a giant arcade.
Fresca?
Yeah.
You're not starting out early today?
No, it's fucking it's 10 o'clock. I got to go get... I got things to do, man. I got to go to the mall, man.
That would have been hilarious. You're all just slosh. You're like, all right, I'm going to go get my kids.
Right? What do you mean I can't pick them up?
What do you mean this isn't my car?
It's my time. I'm allowed... It's my time. Just kidding. All fucking pissy.
That's great.
That's exactly it, isn't it? What's going on over there?
It's not playtime.
I guess we can start the show.
All right.
Welcome to the Skids Podcast, and I'm Shane Kopke, and here's Tim Gage and Kevin McNichols.
Kevin, goddammit.
Yep, goddammit.
Need some hot buttons for that, dude. You should set that up on your end, Shane. That way it's quicker.
It would be nice. The thing is, yeah, we'll have to record it at the end.
And then
we'll
that
just
way
have
you,
to actually
you
do
literally
it.
Have just two, three.
Well, the thing is, sometimes this has to buffer, which is
actually that's true. We do need to add those to here.
Yeah.
And then I can cut that down.
Yeah.
The Tim Gage one.
Yeah.
Because that would be funnier if we cut it down.
Yeah, because sometimes I'll press it and it'll just sit there and
half a minute pause.
Yeah.
And then the Kevin part, yeah, we can put that on here because I can just get rid of these two. This is the intro and outro.
Yeah.
And that would be both part of the intro.
Yeah, well, we still got to get you a sound file too, so. We have yet to figure out a good shape.
Now, the only one that would be good is the movie Shane, where the kids yell at Shane at the end.
Sort of like, I don't know.
And Shane's dead.
Yeah. I'm trying to think of something that rhymes with cocky, but I can't think of it. Coffee?
There we go.
You know, just sound of a percolator or something.
Floppy?
Like that. I don't know.
Yeah, coffee.
Floppy?
I don't know. John Coffee, like the drink, only spelled different.
John Coffee.
John?
Like the drink, only spelled different.
John Coffee?
Yeah, that's from fucking
Green Mile.
I haven't seen that movie since the 90s.
Is that when it came out?
Yeah.
Did it come out in the 90s?
I think like 96, 95?
Here we go.
Look it up, Kevin. Look it up. That's your thing.
Who fucking cares?
Oh,
when it came
1999.
Out?
Okay. Was right.
I was a little off, but
who
yeah.
Still,
who
said
gives
you
a
got
fucking
it right.
Shit? Apparently, 90s. Tom Hanks is a pedophile from what's floating around the internet.
That's been floating around for a while from the crazy people.
Yeah, a lot of crazies are starting to oust.
Out.
Everything
oust would be
I've
pushing
seen,
someone out.
But the thing
outing
is,
someone would be showing their colors.
Everything I've seen, I haven't seen any actual hard evidence.
No.
It's just like
Kevin did when
photos.
He was a child with Tom Hanks. He saw all the hard
he
evidence.
He got some hard
it was
evidence.
When he was filming The Burbs.
That was a good movie, too. I really liked
a good
that
movie.
One.
I don't know.
You need to really trust your neighbors.
I was his
I've
first.
Never, I don't think I've ever seen that at all.
Well, that's a good
you
one.
You didn't see The Burbs? Oh, that's
no.
Cool.
That's pretty. Hey, Pinocchio, where are you going? And that guy's dressed up in lederhosen. The neighbors were fucking creepy as shit. I think one of them was an SNL star, too. I can't remember what he also played.
Oh, yeah, there was an ex-SNL star that's also a potential Tom Hanks-ery.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Pete Davidson?
No, don't.
Mr. Butthole Eyes?
No, it was Horatio Sanz, I think.
Allegedly.
I could believe
really?
That. Yeah, that guy's that, fucking, he's a piece of shit.
Type his name in, I don't there we go.
There he is.
He's a cokehead, too.
Yeah, I've
big
heard some not
yeah,
so great things
him.
About him.
Yeah, that's allegedly he did a lot of that shit at the like after parties, bringing like 15-year-olds and 16-year-olds.
Yes, I heard that's what I was hearing about, too.
Yeah, there we go.
There it is, right there.
first fucking thing you click on.
Yeah, usually if it's the first thing, that's not a good sign
yeah.
for you.
Yeah. He didn't have enough money to
recently
to put
settled
that down.
Underage abuse lawsuit.
Oh, yeah. Look, that's the thing.
It's money.
If you knew that you could get money, would you go back and be like, you know what? Fuck it. I'll hang out with Michael Jackson for a weekend.
No, I wouldn't.
I don't know, man. A weekend and money?
Yeah, but that's penis on you, dude.
No. According to all the allegations, he didn't put his stuff on them. He just was really nice. Gave him massages with his mouth on their genitals.
Jesus, dude.
That's still allegation.
I don't think there's any amount of money that I'd want to do that for. That's pretty crazy.
I don't know, man. You get a blowjob and money.
From a dude.
How much money?
Kevin's on the right track, Tim.
So there's a price tag. You guys have an amount.
There's always a price tag,
nah,
Tim.
I don't know, dude. That's, I don't know. It's not that I'm homophobic, but that's not that's
I don't
not
know, bro.
What if someone was like, we will give your children $1 billion each?
Oh, for my kids?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I took a shot.
Oh, she's weird. Yeah.
For my kids? Fuck yeah.
That's so dumb.
Yeah. Not for
like
myself.
A little bit of horror.
It's called
a
sacrifice,
lifetime
Shane.
Of
look it up.
Yeah, but if somebody said the same thing to you and said, we'll give you $1 billion. Oh, no. Now your kids get $500 million each because you could just give it to them.
I didn't think of it that way.
You're an idiot.
Well, it's just something I never considered, you know, as an option of giving it to my children, yeah.
Well, why wouldn't there be? It's your fucking money.
I don't know.
Kevin, what's your price? My guess is Kevin's price is somewhere around $75.
$60.
Oh, come on. If I was going to do it, I would at least make it so I could get a computer.
You know? As long as you give me a new computer.
Yeah. Kevin's new computer with all the fixings, baby, and then I'm in.
Yeah, what? Why does Kevin have like a lisp today?
I think it's just the idea of him haggling for a fucking computer. No, I gotta have a better sound card than that. That's not gonna work for me.
I won't take
listen,
that crappy
sir.
Buick.
Listen, sir, I need another 20 on top of that.
I said curved monitor. Yeah. Just see you.
That's not 8K, sir. I want 8K.
Curved monitors are great.
Yeah.
I've got two.
That's cool.
Do you have a curved monitor?
I don't care.
Kevin, do you have a curved monitor?
I do not.
Yeah, look at you fucking douchebags. No curved monitors?
I don't care, man. The only thing this new video game came out, you know, the Star Wars Survivor.
Yeah.
Speaking of, you know, monitors.
I heard a lot of people are pissed about that one.
Well, it's because you can't play it on the original Xbox One. You have to buy the Xbox XS to play it.
Oh, that's why everyone's
pissed?
It's
only on that platform.
Did you buy it?
No. One, it's back ordered as a motherfucker.
I thought you said you played it.
No, I haven't played it. I won't play it because I'm not down to drop $600 to play a video game yet. Especially, like I said, the XS's are back ordered for a long
time. Wait, so you
time.
Can't get it for PC
yet? So now they're the new PlayStation?
Well, you can get one, but you have to get the Forza package because no one plays Forza. So they sent all these packages out that no one wants to fucking pay $100 extra for a game you're not going to fucking play.
It's not that nobody plays it. It's just that you really do need all the sim shit to play it.
What do you...
It's a much better game if you have the steering wheel.
That's what I mean. And that's, sent out... I mean, like, I went to GameStop. And I was like, so what do they run now? And they're like $5.99. But for $6.70, you can get the Forza package because we don't have the regular ones in. You can get the same console, but it comes with Forza for another $80. And I was like, I just can't... I can't good conscience buy a game I'm never going to play.
I know. I kind of feel bad that I got God of War. I like it. It's fun.
I heard good things about
it.
I've heard a lot of good things about it, yeah.
I'm not
it's
as
got
into,
a following, for sure.
But yeah. I'm not as into the whole Norse mythology. Not Norse, but what is it? Greek?
Well, it's kind of...
Greek, Roman, Greek, Norse, all amazing.
Well, yeah.
That was a groundbreaking game, man. It changed a lot about
that. Groundbreaking?
Because the Kratos is from Greek mythology, and then he's like doing Norse mythology in that game.
That's
a mix of things.
That style of gameplay started a whole series of films. I mean, that's Jedi Survivor is based off of, that same style of gameplay.
Yeah.
To me, I like things more grounded in some reality.
Okay. Except
for zombies.
Well, you're kind of a historian in that aspect.
I'm a historian. I'm going to wear my monocle to the next show.
Well, it just seems that's things you're into, for sure. You like history.
I do.
You know, you get your flight simulator that's based on a lot of historical events. I get that.
Yeah. No, I do like games like that, or based more in like modern reality, like for first-person shooters. I like tactical military style.
Yeah,
shooters.
You're the Tom Clancy style stuff.
Not as much anymore because they went away from that.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
They went way far
yeah.
away from that. They went more arcade
they
than
did.
Anything.
Yeah,
it kind of sucks.
Well, that's why I never played it, because I can't stand the tactical.
Oh, I love the
stuff.
Tactical stuff.
I always like the tactical stuff, too. But the arcade stuff just, I don't know. It just feels
a place, but it's usually not within a tactical genre.
Not that type
from
of game, yeah.
a specific company that dealt with tactical only.
Oh, fuck
right.
that.
And
right.
made all their money off of the tactical mm-hmm. side. And they're like, nah, let's
and
just
realistically,
get rid of that.
Well, that's because they wanted to compete with real games like Call of Duty and Battlefield.
But that's not how they compete, though. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Like they.
No, that's how they do now. That's how a lot of places compete.
It's not, though, because they're not going to take that market share.
No,
it's true. It's going to be a tough market to beat.
Well, you've
these
got
guys.
Those games like Call of Duty that have basically are fixed into those positions, you know, where so many people have been buying them for so long.
Yeah, that's synonymous with first-person shooter now.
Exactly.
Call
fixed into those positions, like old Milktoast over here's girlfriend.
Milktoast?
Yeah, I just think of him as like, we only do it missionary. That's it.
How is that Milktoast? I don't get that. That's odd. What an odd phrase.
It's not odd.
Old
Milktoast. That is actually the fucking phrase for that.
Milktoast is like a fence hitter. You know,
yes.
It's like
well,
sort
not,
of like
it's,
I mean,
it's just very bland.
Right. Basic.
It's bland.
I can't
say
I've ever heard that.
That's why I thought it was funny when you said fixed in position. That's a good line.
It's a disc. It's a toast is a breakfast dish consisting of toasted bread and warm milk.
Yeah, that's Kevin.
With sugar and butter.
His doesn't have the sugar in it though.
sounds spicy.
Kevin's just bread and milk.
It's because of my raging diabetes.
Timid, meek, unassertive. Yeah, there you go. Okay, I can see that, but
yeah,
I don't see
that's
being,
why I said that it was meek. Funny. Milktoast, and then only missionary. that's what it would be, right?
Such an odd phrase.
If you were straight Milktoast,
like
That's just oh, really she, odd.
You've oh, never oh, heard that no. phrase.
It's a first
like,
time.
She wants, hey, fuck is she wants to try a different position. Like, honey,
you're like,
we've talked about this.
Fine.
I've said through the whole of the underwear, and that's it.
Women don't get on top. Ugh, that's disgusting. What are you, some harlot?
Don't look at me.
You fucking hooker. How could you? You betrayed me.
Where have you been learning this shit? This is witchcraft.
How am I going to face people Mom. At church?
Get in, Mom, get in here.
Mom. Mom, you need to show her what you showed me.
Embarrassing. So
for anyone that's missed it, this has been an ongoing thing about Kevin. That we somehow made up the fact that he was homeschooled, which is never the case.
Never happened.
And that his mom taught him sexual education while watching movies and tits. It was fucked up. It's kind of been
I remember the first time, Beverly Hills Cop 2.
She's like, son, how do you feel when you see that?
I can see you're excited, son.
Mom, why do we have to watch movies naked?
Jesus, this is like fucking Norman Bates type shit right there. Oh my god.
Hey
god.
Man, even Norman Bates' mom was Wait, I was gonna no, it was Norman.
I was gonna say
his mom.
We come to find out later, Kevin never had a mom. this is all this
he
wears
just
the stilettos the whole time.
It's stomping his foot.
He's dressed like Two-Face, except half of it's just god, a dress dude. And he's naked on the
hey,
other side.
You know that movie Psycho? I watch it. Every night.
Yeah, no, it's a documentary to Kevin.
Yeah, it is. It's a history
flick. It's about my grandfather.
I believe it, actually. That's a disgusting ribbon, but it needs to stay for sure.
Yeah, no, that's why it's funny.
Yuck.
Well, it started out with that whole, he was talking about watching a movie with his mom when he was younger. It was like a horror movie, right? I think it was some sort of horror movie. Some weird shit like that.
Yeah, something like that.
And then, of course, we tossed in really fucked up shit in this scenario.
Yeah.
That's what makes it funny.
Yeah.
You don't have to explain that thing.
No, I just thought because it's not for us. It's for the listeners.
Well, I'm pretty sure our listeners.
Any audience member watching that has not been watching those
I'm pretty
episodes.
Sure that they were already tuned out.
We get about 5 good seconds of they're going to just talk about this again.
That's right. We're about 5 minutes.
12 minutes in. Get the fuck out of here.
That's about all their attention spans are worth these days.
So there's another shooting.
No, I haven't been watching the news or listening to it.
I didn't hear about that.
Shit.
Yeah, I went down in Texas. Some dude went into a mall. I think he killed like 8 people.
Jesus.
Something like that.
Who was he?
But
who
I
fucking
know,
cares?
Some dude?
Some piece of shit.
But the cop, there was a cop apparently that was close to the mall when the shots started happening. And he got there quick and just blasted the dude.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. That's you'd what
you're
supposed to do.
In Texas, there'd be more armed
you,
people.
You would think
in the
so,
mall.
But
well, there was that church there. The guy came into the church. Oh, and like, that was the congregation was fucking strapped.
Did you see
that
video?
That guy got
that?
Fucking annihilated.
Yeah, man.
Although he did shoot someone with a shotgun like right away.
He got away with one kill, I think, or 2 kills or something like that.
He hit 2 people. Yeah. I think he killed one and then hit another person, but
yeah,
with
then,
a shotgun. I mean, it's a shotgun.
And then this dude pulled his gun out, just blah.
Yeah.
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 You don't go to a church.
The guy in the corner.
A church in Texas.
Yeah, the guy in the corner got
him. From a distance, he hits him.
It was a
like,
good shot.
He was a good 35 feet from the guy and fucking nailed him.
Was he using a 9 or?
Just a, I don't know. In Texas, I mean, I just assume everyone's got
cold
a
fucking, peacemaker.
Yeah, everyone's running a fucking cold peacemaker and like some fucking Henry rifle.
There it is.
They're all fucking sitting there.
An old repeater.
Yeah. Henry repeater.
Those are great guns.
Exactly.
I would love to have one.
I would love to have one too.
Who
would?
Those are like, what, $2,000-$3,000, man. They're fucking
they're
expensive.
Awesome.
I saw
the nice ones are anyway.
I saw the little I don't know what
there's one called a chipmunk that's pretty fun. It's a 22.
See, I thought that I found one that or one of my friend's dad's has this. It's a like a pistol version of it.
Oh wow.
But it's still got a short stock on it, although it's not counted as a stock because of its overall length, it doesn't count. Huh. But it's a little 30-30 lever action with an oversized lever on it. So instead of the small levers that fits basically just your hand, you know, it's oversized. So it's like that much taller on the lever itself.
Shane's demonstrating with the length of his penis.
Yes. 40 inches.
I think he's embellishing a bit.
No, not 40.
From the ground.
Yes, I'm not even that tall. Tim? Jesus.
That's what your penis does. It inverts. It goes up your throat from the inside.
Mine's actually in my nostril.
Yeah, it just bubbles out every now and then. Oh, someone's excited.
Every lady's like, what? Why aren't you pulling down your pants? Like, yeah, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
Going in deep.
Call me Pinocchio.
Give it a whiff. Yuck. Jesus.
Geppetto, can you hear me?
Paints a picture right there, doesn't it? Yuck.
Dude, yeah. It's weird doing the show on a fucking Sunday.
I was just thinking the
weird.
Same thing.
It is weird.
10 o'clock in the morning. Early. It's not too bad, but
I don't mind the 10 o'clock, dude. That would be awesome if that's just when we did the shows, you know? No, come on, follow us, fucking listen to us, motherfuckers.
I'm only available.
Like, subscribe.
Yeah, every other.
We can't do it all the time on Sunday.
Like, subscribe, send us money.
That'd be really nice if we could get some money. That'd be cool. That'd be really nice, you guys.
Preferably
some sponsors, some more sponsors.
Just send me the money. I'll let them know.
So Shane can fucking he can.
He'll let us know when
us.
He spent it.
So I'll let them know.
Guys, so I got a new computer.
It. Hey guys, we got good news. We got $5,000, and I turned it into $247, guys.
In 3 hours, it's amazing.
Like, what the fuck happened? Well, I put it on red, and
well, Johnny Chan came into this casino I was in, and.
Yes, I tried that Matt Damon him.
Yeah,
he was
no
a fucking
shit. It didn't work.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't know that movie. You don't know,
that
reference.
I do too.
Yeah, it's a good movie.
You know who Johnny Chan is?
Yeah, that's the guy from I know the reference of the movie, isn't that Matt Damon
didn't he work with Chris Tucker?
We quoted that, didn't we? Pay him his money.
Yes.
Yeah. Pay him his money.
He beat me.
I just like the idea that you would think that, yeah, Johnny Chan, him and Chris Tucker did that Rush Hour movie, yeah. Right?
No, it's Jackie Chan.
I know that. It would have been funny if you didn't.
Well, no, I know that movie. It's a good movie. Yeah. It's Rounders, isn't it?
Rounders.
Yeah, Rounders. Now, Johnny Chan
talk
was
about that
champion
movie
poker player.
Yeah, he was talking about that. He actually had the chance
to play. I think he won back-to-back years.
Yeah. I think he did.
89, 90,
he's not the one that wears the sunglasses upside down. Who's that guy?
No, I don't. Who is that guy?
But he was making a good run for a while.
Oh, was that Raymer?
I don't remember. I don't know. I don't follow the circuit, so I don't
know. I think that's the guy that.
But I remember seeing him in a couple.
Well, he had a nickname of something like the dinosaur guy or fossil guy or whatever the fuck it was. Because I think he did.
The statue or something.
Marcel
like
Luske. Or Luske?
Marcel Luske? I know that guy, too. Yeah. I swear it was the other guy, but pull up a picture so you can fucking see it. Jesus, man.
Right here?
Right. I know
that's
that
the only way that Tim's going to know. Tim's not going to just look at words.
I don't care, dude.
This dude
is that
right
the guy?
I just remember a guy having his sunglasses
is
on.
Is that the guy?
I guess, yes.
Yeah?
Yeah, I can tell by that blue.
The guy that looks like Max Headroom with upside-down sunglasses.
Yep. He doesn't look like Max Headroom.
I forgot about him, dude. I don't know what happened to that guy. Is he dead?
Probably.
He's old as shit, dude.
Mafia's trying to pull in all their losses.
Let's see if he's dead, man. What happened to Marcel Luske?
I saw a list of recent actors and actresses that have died.
That we don't know about?
Well, yeah, that's what was odd, too.
That
is
odd, right?
I didn't hear that person died, but yeah, a couple faces.
Dude, yeah. Unfortunate. Well, that's... I've been, you know, watching, like, history of, like, poker stuff. And hearing some of the shit that's happened in that recently. Or
he's still around.
It's like, what the fuck?
People,
you know?
Breaking arms and shit like that.
Just weird. There was one that dude fucking, I forgot about this, but he got robbed by his ex-girlfriend for like a ton of money.
They call him the Flying Dutchman, I guess.
Oh, see, that's who I'm thinking of. Greg Raymer. Yeah, because he wore upside down he wore the weird fucking dinosaur glasses. That's why.
Yeah,
that's why he got the dinosaur.
I remember that.
Yeah. But no, the
Fossil Man is what they call him.
Yeah, Fossil Man. There we go. Yeah, because he had a dinosaur fossil that he had on the table all the time.
Oh, cool.
But no, there was a dude that after winning the World Series, like he had this girlfriend for a while. They broke up, and then she got somebody to go in and like armed rob him at his house.
Oh shit.
Yeah, and they got into his safe. Like, they beat the shit out of him until he opened the safe, because he wasn't opening the safe. And they stole, like, $400,000 or $500,000 out of their safe.
Who keeps that amount of money at their house?
If you're a poker player and...
You need it on hand that quick,
you,
huh?
you, some places won't give you the line of credit, so you have to bring in the cash.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah. So there are, and there's some private games where you have to have cash only, you know? Now, a lot of those private games will have security. Like, they'll have an actual... You give the money to somebody that goes through a safe area, shit like that. Uh-huh. But there's places that get robbed like that. Dude, it's like the Old West, but with technology.
Right.
You know?
Interesting.
Fucking crazy. And Doyle Brunson's talked about numerous times where he was at games that just got fucking robbed right in the middle of them.
Good old Doyle Brunson.
Yeah.
We did a Dave Chappelle episode about that.
Which one was that?
That was the dice game.
Yeah,
yeah, they were
dice.
Craps.
Ashy Larry. Ashy Larry.
Powder flying up like that shit.
And Ashy Larry shows up at the very end. He's like, "All right, man. All right, I got another $200.
He's in his underwear.
And he's, yeah. Dude's just like, "Get that here, motherfucker." He's like, "Oh, man."
I think that was the redhead comedian guy was one of the
Bill Burr.
Yeah, Bill Burr was a commentator of that.
Yeah.
That
was he was also funny. the race draft. When they did the race
draft. Yeah.
That was one of the funniest skits ever.
Pretty fucking... I mean, the whole...
We the Chinese pick the Wu-Tang Clan.
Konnichiwa, motherfuckers.
Fucking love that sketch.
Y'all need to diversify so y'all bonds.
Good. What are you doing?
I'm finding a sound that we need.
Oh, which sound?
X-Files.
Oh.
Are we allowed to do that? I thought we said we couldn't.
No, we can. It's just, it's a short one. We can't. There's like a certain amount of time.
Dude, it's so weirdly arbitrary.
It really is. And it's like some songs you can play more of than others. It's really strange.
So here's the odd thing. When it comes to audio and audio mostly format type things.
Jesus Christ.
I'm trying to kill you.
The rules are really weird.
The rules are really weird when it comes to like songs. Copyrighted audio, all this weird shit. But when it comes to video, it depends. It's so wide open in the video spectrum.
The video stuff falls more under fair use, especially if you're commenting on stuff.
If you're commenting on it, it mostly falls under that.
Yeah.
Well, yet people will still strike
stuff.
You.
Like the
they can.
You
yeah.
can't use the Star Wars soundtrack at all in anything.
Dude, do you remember who the Actman was?
So
do you remember what his whole big debacle when he was fucking getting demonetized and all that shit?
I think so.
There was that dude. So there was the dude that
happened not too long ago, right?
We talked about this guy
when
Elden Ring came out. So there's this dude that was fucking commenting on Elden Ring, saying it was the worst game he's ever played, and they should make it easier, all this shit, right? It's just, look, if you're not good at the game, who cares?
Yeah.
It may not be your cup of tea, and that's fine. But he commented on it, and everybody attacked him for it. Because they were like, dude, that's just, you're not into that style of game.
Yeah.
So you don't really have any leg to stand on here. Sure. First off, you didn't beat the game. You didn't even go through the game. So you didn't learn how to do the game. Uh-huh. And so they attacked the shit out of him. So then he started fucking going back at everybody and copyright striking all of them. Every single one of them. And then it just kept going back and forth and back and forth between him and the Actman.
What's a copyright strike?
So when you get a copyright strike, it's because you've taken something that's copyrighted and you've used it on your channel to benefit you, even though it's not your property.
Oh, so they're using bits of his video to comment on
it. Yes and no. They're using little tiny pieces of it, which is not under the copyright strike rules. However... They don't go in and look at it when I make a complaint on there, which I've never done. But if I did on YouTube, they don't look into it. Uh-huh. They just automatically put it through, and then the person has to appeal it.
Right.
So that's how it works.
That's kind of bullshit, right?
It's bullshit.
So he attacked the shit out of Actman. Actman ended up it got so big that.
People
Actman,
were making videos about the
well,
whole thing
Actman
too.
Ended up getting fucking demonetized.
Oh,
which his whole life is making money on YouTube.
Yeah,
so that's going. That's getting fired right there.
Oh no.
Right? So, I guess this dude. I can't remember his name. See if you can find the dude's name. But anyway, this dude just ended up getting everybody thought he was kind of a piece of shit because the way he did his content, the fact that in his old stuff. He would like bash gay people and everybody like all the people on the left and stuff. But then now he's like kind of going back and
you follow the money.
Yes, and that's exactly what it is. Yeah. He's one of those that you can obviously see he's following like what's new. Oh, that's gonna make me cash. And so everyone was like, this guy's kind of a piece of shit. Well, now he's actually a piece of shit. He got arrested recently
for touching kids.
I don't think it was that. I think it was domestic abuse.
Wow.
Allegedly. So, you know, I got to say allegedly, even though we don't know who the fuck he is. What's his name?
Actman?
No, it's Actman. There was the guy that fucking came after him is
yeah,
who
I'm
it was.
Trying to
and that guy went after everybody. I think he went even after Asmongold. He went after...
Was it the one, the video that he make the, what was it?
It was
the worst Elden Ring hot takes video?
No, that's going to be in it. Holy shit. I'm going to just telegram somebody.
My internet could be pretty bad. I got a lot of stuff online right now.
Who knows? This computer's old, too.
My carrier's getting pretty bad, too, actually.
How about I just type in Actman controversy, quantum TV.
Whoa, it's Quantum TV? Okay.
Yeah, Quantum TV. Let's see. I'm going to look up. It's Quantum TV Arrested.
That was his name, was Quantum
TV? No, that's his page name.
Oh.
Yep, Quantum TV.
So he was arrested.
Fascinating.
So Actman said Quantum TV weaponized his audience, inciting them to find private information about the Actman.
Yeah, no, that's the other thing. He tried fucking, what's that called? Damn it.
Doxing?
Doxing. He tried doxing him.
Well, it says, eventually, Quantum TV acquired the Actman's mother's personal phone number
and
called
actually
her. Called her to insist that she make the Actman
take down his video.
Like,
this guy was a piece of shit.
That's fucking terrible.
Yeah, he was a piece of shit.
I mean, if it's free information, but this should be a line you
can't
cross.
No, like, why
even
bring
if
in the family?
Even if it's
you know?
Free information, I think that there's definitely things you shouldn't cross.
There's a lot,
like, Tim, if I got mad at you, I know where your parents live.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to go over to your parents and be like, Tim's mean.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's stupid.
Tell your son to stop.
Although they'd believe everything.
They're like, no, we understand. Come inside. Let's talk. That's exactly how it would go down.
I'd walk out a Mormon.
That's exactly how it would go down, too.
So he got arrested, but I think he got arrested for... But it was just crazy, that whole thing that you know, that whole thing that goes down and you're like, this guy's kind of a piece of shit, and then he just kind of proves it. You know,
well,
like,
yeah.
By, like, beating it. But his bond amount was only, like, $500. Can't be that much.
No, then. It must have been a really low, like,
it wasn't
charge.
Any Kenny stuff. Well, it was a felony.
$500 for a felony? To get
bailed out? Well, the
DAs
are pretty shitty these days, so that's not
true.
A big surprise.
That's true.
First-degree felony, obstructing justice.
Probably hinder... Probably just wasn't talking or something like that.
Obstructing justice, huh?
Hindering witness... domestic violence. Yeah.
Ouch.
Yeah. So he got arrested for obstruction of justice on two of them, it looks like. So I don't even think he's been charged with the domestic violence part. Otherwise, I don't think the bond would be $500. So, but yeah, felony obstruction of justice. Usually obstruction of justice is, I think, like, is that a felony? I guess it would be, right?
I have no fucking clue.
I'm not sure.
Tim, you would know better than anyone.
I don't know the law.
You would know better than anybody.
How do I? I have no fucking input on this whatsoever. It's like, yes,
so,
it's a fucking, it's a hangable offense.
Well, you're looking.
Yeah.
You know,
Tim, we're talking about.
Well, speaking of which, Florida, though.
Why would
you heard about that, right? Florida, they passed a law, the bill to the death sentence for pedophiles.
Okay.
If you're convicted of molesting a minor, you will
this
be
is,
put to
okay,
death.
So this is where I might not agree with that.
In case a person's innocent and it's a whole foster parent shit.
Yeah, that's something that could be potential.
Yep.
Yeah, that's terrible.
So it's
the other one that is, like, I don't know, 18 and 17. Like,
oh, wait, no.
They're like, you know what? I don't like that guy that's fucking my daughter that's 17. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get him arrested because he's 18.
I'm going to get him
so,
killed.
And
hey.
He's going to get murdered by the state.
Yep.
So,
yeah, that's where it gets hairy. And now if they said...
No, I think they put an age limit.
Well, yeah. Now if they said that, like, you're 18 and you're fucking a 12-year-old, okay.
There was... I can pull it up, but I'm not going to.
So
say
it
they,
says
they
it's a
like
class
it.
2
DeSantis
misdemeanor.
DeSantis has yet to sign it, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
That's Washington, though.
No.
He doesn't live in Washington.
Well, no. See, actually, this is
well, he
NC.
Got two obstruction of justice felonies.
Do you know what state he lived in?
I don't know.
No.
Okay. State of denial, because he was denying that he did it.
State of decay.
Well, it does depend on the
cool
on the state, because in...
Freeze coming out.
I didn't know that.
It looks like it's basically, like, in some places it's a class 2 felony. If you get federal obstruction of justice, that's a felony.
Well, he got two of them.
Yeah.
So, and it was like tampering with witnesses or
something like
that.
Do we know what state
he was in? I just said no.
Okay, you can look him up.
Wait, Jesus Shane. Fucking Christ. Shane. Do you know what state he's in? Why do you keep asking me? I'm holding a microphone.
Shit up. I don't fucking know. And I've been looking at this, you fucking
I'm doing
liar.
This, Kevin. I'm talking.
I'm going to say Connecticut.
Connect I cut.
Connecticut.
Connect I cut.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Why are you looking for Actman?
Who fucking cares?
Isn't that the guy that got arrested?
No, that would be Quantum TV.
It was Quantum TV. Okay.
The Actman is the guy. He's the good guy in this one.
Like, does anybody
stop
know
fucking trying to attack him?
Is it just someone you know, or is it a pretty famous person?
What?
This person that we're
Actman?
Talking
about. Actman? No, he's pretty fucking famous for, I mean, YouTube famous.
He's in Florida.
So he's an influencer.
Ooh. No, he's not an influencer, Tim.
That's all right.
Influencer is not the same thing as somebody that's a content creator. Content creation is totally different. Influencer does nothing.
Yeah, they don't.
And then they just show up for bottle service, and they're like, hey, guess who's going to be here? I don't know who that is. I
did something like that on that movie with the Workaholic cast.
Yeah, that's
okay.
That was fucking hilarious. What was that
called? I haven't seen that
okay,
one.
Okay, so in Florida, it says that the penalties for obstruction of justice can range from misdemeanors to felonies depending on the situation, the person involved, and whether or not violence was used.
See, guys?
So it all depends.
And you thought you'd learn nothing from the show.
I still haven't
learned it all depends on the situation.
But
itself.
But like I said, he was charged with two felonies of obstruction of justice, which is crazy.
So the state must have thought that he did something bad enough to hit him with felonies then. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, obviously doxing like family. And,
well, but
and
he
that
didn't
kind
do
of
it. But he didn't. The thing is, though, nothing that he did in relation to the Actman is this. This is domestic violence.
Right.
He didn't beat up him and the Actman
okay,
aren't
so
married.
This, yeah, what this was a separate one.
Are you
okay.
following the story?
I didn't know that was why.
Well, I'm not following the story. It's fucking
well, no,
stupid,
I thought we were still talking about these two shit, and that's why he got arrested.
Well, no, I was just bringing him up because he got arrested recently to show more how he's more of a piece of shit.
Okay, well, I didn't know this was a separate thing. That's because I was looking shit up while
I had
telling
to,
the fucking story.
But what I'm saying is I had to bring up the past stuff. Otherwise, you have no idea who this guy is.
I still don't.
Okay, I was still looking shit up when you were telling that part of the story.
Kevin, you could just go, you know what? You're right. Let's move on.
Yes, please. Let's move on.
Get the fuck on.
It's a really... I mean, it's riveting. I'm at the edge of my seat. I'm sitting here playing fucking solitaire while he's talking about Actman.
Dude.
It's pretty good.
You asked if he was, like, famous and shit.
Yeah, well, I've never
and
heard
you
of
don't
him.
Know what
and I've already forgotten about
and
him.
And you don't know what the difference is between an influencer or a content creator.
Yeah, it's because I don't care.
Fuck you.
There we go.
Yeah, fuck you, Tim.
speaking of which, has nothing to do with anything, but have you seen the new quarters? I showed you guys that picture of the new quarter. The 2022 quarter.
Oh.
The back
yeah,
of it that's
yeah,
got
yeah,
like
yeah.
some Asian actress from the 60s, no, from like the 30s or something like that.
Is that who it is?
Yeah, I really? Googled her. I had to find out who the hell
I'd never even heard of her before.
I mean, I understand Sacagawea and all these other important political figures,
sure.
But to put an entertainer on the back of our currency, it seems really, really odd to me.
You got
to
remember it's all a popularity contest.
Well, that's, yeah. I think that's
everything
what
is.
Yeah, it's part of that. It's reached our coinage now. That's what I found so bizarre is that wokeism or being woke has now applied to our monetary or to our tender. It's so interesting to me, and it also
it's
at the same time kind of frustrating.
Odd.
It's like there could be far more important people to put on the back of our
oh absolutely absolutely
then you know I'm not saying this person isn't important.
I mean,
or was didn't play a role but
yeah
plays a role in the actual United States of America's I don't know.
Right. If you're going to choose women to put on the back, there's plenty of women that have done far more important things.
Yeah, Amelia yeah. Earhart or something like that. You know,
sure.
But
Amelia Earhart's not Asian, though.
No, that's
whatever.
Exactly
there's
my point.
There's still other Asian women yeah. that have done more, you know, more you know, important things.
Lucy Liu. Let's put her on there.
I still think Amy Wong from Futurama.
Why not? You know, why not? Kevin, you made a good point, though. We'll put Ellen DeGeneres on our fucking $10 bill or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Or no, yeah,
this
Ellen
is,
Page or whatever.
This
yeah.
is Idiocracy.
I was going to say,
we are there, yeah.
It's strange that we've become a parody and even more. Fuddruckers will be buttfuckers very soon.
Eventually,
I know,
yes,
yeah.
they will. That's what I mean. But
soon enough,
we're
going to drive by and go, buttfuckers?
Our
what the
presidents,
fuck is that?
Our presidents are celebrities.
That's always been the case. Stop it. That's crazy. This is why I was bringing up.
No, but not that's in the bullshit. Way that he's referring to.
Bullshit.
Though.
That's bullshit. They've always been celebrities. Have always been the most popular person at the time.
But I'm not.
But yeah.
Shane, that's not what he's talking about.
I'm talking about
he's
the political.
He's talking about like a fucking pro wrestler, like yeah, that guy becoming be like you know the Terry Crews character becoming a president.
Yeah. That's what
that's
I'm referencing.
Absurdity. However,
right. That's what he's referring
presidents
to.
Have always been the obviously, most popular person at the time.
Obviously. But
yeah,
that's
but
the way it works.
These are individuals that are in the political field.
Yeah.
Yes and no. I mean, because Trump was never in the political
that's
field.
That's what I'm saying. And now we literally have a celebrity was our president and could potentially be our president again.
Yeah, but...
But has no okay, real fine. Political ties well, except for money.
But
Grant
Trump
was a huge
business.
Celebrity when he became president.
I heard, you know,
he wasn't a political guy. He was a military 80s, guy.
The 80s president.
Yeah, but
yeah,
was an actor.
Yeah, I know.
Reagan. But I get what he's saying. He's more talking about when he's talking about celebrities. He's talking about like entertainers and shit.
Yeah,
you know, not.
That's
no, I understand what he's talking about, but what I'm saying is it's really no different. I know it sounds different, but it's really no different.
It
instead
is.
Of getting just a straight bullshit is. Artist that is already in the system, you get somebody else that's just a popular person. It's always been whoever is a popular person.
Well, no, I'm not debating that. We're not debating whether
it's
a popularity contest.
Yeah.
It's exactly
yeah.
what it
that's,
is because it's
always,
voted on.
Yeah. No,
what I'm
I get
saying
that.
Is when you're voting in someone that has nothing to do with the political field, you know, that wasn't raised in politics, it doesn't have a political background.
You know, being, like, yeah. Sasha Gray became president
that's
one day or something.
I would say you know? That, I would say that even Trump had political.
He had
leanings.
Political ties because of money.
Not because
he was
just
also
because of money,
a business
power,
guy.
Influence. The fact yeah. that his father was a, you know, what
yeah.
multi-billionaire or not billionaire?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Well, then that's saying like Musk being our president. You know,
yeah,
let's
that wouldn't
Elon
be that
Musk.
Crazy. But you can't elect him because he's South African.
Yeah, he's
well,
not
he's
American.
Been, yeah,
I mean he is, but he's not.
Be a citizen for how long?
You have to be born here.
You have to be born here.
Really?
Yes.
Yep.
I didn't know that.
Do you not yeah. know anything? Did you take civics class in fucking
high
school?
I've soon drank
well, that's
away,
why,
that's
for instance,
sure.
That's why, for instance, Arnold Schwarzenegger never ran for
what
presidency.
What did you say?
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh, he changed that up a bit.
No, that's what I said.
That's not what you said. Christ. You're going to have to bleep Arnold's name.
No, I won't. Anyway, he said straight up he didn't run for president.
He said it, right?
He wanted to run for president, but he couldn't. Because he wasn't born here.
Well, yeah. I thought he had to be a citizen for at least 30 years.
No, you
like that,
have to be born here. You have to be at least age 42?
I think it's like 40, 42, something like that.
Or 40. Yeah.
When have we had a president that young?
Obama was pretty
yeah,
close.
Yeah, Obama was one of the
I
youngest.
I think he was like 45,
something like
46.
That. Yeah,
oh,
actually,
shit.
Let's find out.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was super young. I think he was the youngest.
Him and Kennedy were the youngest, I think.
Yeah.
Kennedy, I heard, was a great one.
Yeah, he left it all out there.
He was sure 47. Did.
47. So that's still fairly
yeah. up to
young.
The public,
man, let's see how
he definitely
was.
Opened himself. Dude, I watched the funniest thing. Somebody took. You know how bowling? When you go bowling, they have all those little
hey,
fucking.
JFK was 43.
Well, just a second.
I didn't know that.
Remember? You know how at bowling you have all those little animations and shit. And they're always like fucking terrible, you know.
Oh
like,
yeah.
Or little... they'll show something. And you're like, that's a little over the line. You know what I mean?
Two bowling pins fucking.
Yeah. Well, this one was up.
But only a missionary.
Up yeah. Dealey Avenue in fucking.
Oh.
There's a car with four pins in it, and there's a bowling ball up so in the up in the fucking book depository.
Are you serious?
Yes, no. It's hilarious.
That's so fucked up.
Oh, it's the greatest Strike. Thing I've ever seen. I thought about sending it to you guys too. I thought that was fucking hilarious.
Someone
Holy
put that
shit.
Together and put it up
yeah.
on the monitor. That's funny.
Yeah, it's fucking hilarious.
If you can't laugh about murder, what can you laugh about?
So, yeah, so he
so,
was
yeah.
the youngest at JFK.
JFK was the youngest. Obama was second
So it
youngest.
Is, what, 42 or is it 40?
It's, let's see here.
And we got to get into your little...
little.
Big.
That's why I look forward to every fucking show, man.
But we don't do it every show.
I wish
oh,
we
you
did.
Have to be at least 35 years old.
Okay, 35. Right. I thought it was like 40-something.
Yeah.
I didn't. Now I learned something, Tim.
I thought it was in the 40s. Too.
I thought maybe
thought.
That it's just because the only like presidents we've had has been at that age. Or
yeah,
older.
Yeah. Well, and I guess
who the fuck's gonna trust a 35-year-old?
Biden is the oldest.
Well, no shit.
Had.
He's actually, like, he rises from the ground
every morning. Right? So he was 78 when he was sworn in.
It's scary.
It's fucking terrifying. The guy
can
barely fucking
walk. Did you see that short video
of
some politician walking up to a podium? They were doing a meet and greet, and Biden reaches down to touch his daughter, and the guy swats Biden's hand away.
Did he really?
Yeah, he's like, don't fucking touch my kid or my granddaughter or something like that. It was awkward as fuck. Because he's like patting his hands like, no, get your hands away from
me. Dude,
my
he's
daughter.
Always trying to touch little kids.
That's what
man.
I mean. The guy's, and it, apparently this guy knew something that, well, everyone I think has some sort of inclination towards it, but this guy was not having it. Like, keep your hands off my granddaughter. And she was like maybe 9 or 10 years old.
Jesus. Well, that shit's crazy. Should I start watching Deadwood?
Deadwood's fucking awesome.
I was looking through HBO shows while Deadwood, you were boring me with that fucking whatever you just did.
Deadwood's one of the best Western shows
attention
ever.
Attention spans are so fucking small right now, dude.
Fucking watch Deadwood. It's only three seasons long, and then there's a movie that comes after that. Okay. And it's amazing.
I heard the same about Yellowstone.
Is fucking
I hear Yellowstone's really good, too.
Yeah, my dad's really into Yellowstone.
Yeah,
Yellowstone, I heard, is good, too.
Yeah, my folks are into that one as well. It's odd to know that the lead actor, though, is a redhead. You know, they dyed his beard and his hair and all that. He's actually a pretty good actor, but to see him in that role where he's got a country guy, when I've actually seen him more like a mafioso style, you know, white silk shirt type character. He was in one of the driving movies, whatever the fuck they're called.
Fast and Furious?
Yeah, there's another one coming out, apparently. We're just not getting enough of family, is what it is.
Jesus.
I think it's just called Furious.
God, they should have stopped making those a long time ago.
The fact that they just keep pumping those fuckers out.
Fucking, it's never going to end, man.
It's Vin Diesel, I'm sure. He's like, let's make another one.
None of this shit makes sense with it. Because the first one starts out, and you're like, all right, I mean, it's got one part where you're like, okay, that's a little wonky. But outside of that, it's like, you could probably have a lot of that shit happen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then it goes fucking off the rails.
Flying out of fucking planes and shit.
Dude, like go to
rock,
space.
The Rock.
They go to space,
dude,
Tim.
The Rock holding a fucking helicopter with a chain while he's on top of a vehicle.
Well, that like, I believe.
Oh.
Yeah.
What the fuck was that?
That was what the sound the Rock made when he was holding a helicopter with a chain. He was like, blah, 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 blah.
Well, we should get into
this.
And I
hit my fucking funny bone.
We should get into this conspiracy thing, Kevin.
All right.
Kevin's Conspiracy Corner.
We're starting the conspiracy thing way late, but that's fine. And if we have a long episode, we have a long episode.
So be it.
Well, that was.
That's it?
That's all we get.
That was really good. Do it again, Kevin. Just keep pushing it until we get enough of it.
Just loop it.
They weren't kidding about the short thing on there. It says X-Files theme short.
Well, then see if you can find it long. Why'd you pick the one that said short? Because you just assumed that it would be like 30 seconds.
We didn't want to.
No, there was like I figured it'd be longer than that. That's it.
There used to be another one.
I thought there was too.
Well, copyright lies, buddy. And
there
it is.
XP shut down for some fucking reason.
That's right. Let's do that one. Boo doo doo boop.
What are we talking about today, Kim?
How about I got a better one? How about this?
All right, Conspiracy Corner with Kevin. He's jumping from the tightrope.
Jumping through the tightrope.
So, today on
quantum
the
physics.
Conspiracy Corner, we're going to talk about the Federal Reserve. And
money?
Well, no, not really. What we're going to talk about is what happened right before the creation of the Federal Reserve, because there is a... There's a theory.
The Rothschilds are involved.
Well, that is one aspect. So, but the main there's actually a few different aspects to this story, and they get crazier as it goes on. So, essentially, J.P. Morgan and a bunch of people created the Federal Reserve around the early 1900s. Okay, and so there were people that wanted to prevent the creation of the Federal Reserve for various reasons. And those people were on the Titanic when it went down.
Dun, dun, dun.
And what's interesting is that about this is that J.P. Morgan, who was one of the biggest proponents of the Federal Reserve.
This is the one I wanted
Reserve,
him to talk about.
All right, Shane.
Oh,
do it, Kevin. Go. Go, Kevin. Go. Go.
Let him go.
So
let him talk about it.
JP Morgan owned the White Star Line.
Wrong one.
Now, the White Star Line owned the Titanic.
And the Olympic.
And the Olympic. And there was another
one.
There
was one other one.
But that one doesn't have anything to do with this story.
But the Olympic does.
The Olympic does.
Shane, stop, dude. Look at you so fucking excited. It's like, oh, I can't wait. I can't wait. It's going to be so good.
So, basically, now, J.P. Morgan was actually supposed to be on the Titanic when it set sail for its maiden voyage.
Stop fucking looking at you, Shane. It's just like, pay attention, Tim. This is a good one. This is a really good one.
This is so, one that is also good.
I get it.
Now,
I get it. You know,
everybody knows
like
the Titanic.
You're the guy at the fucking movie theater. It's like, oh, what's happening next? Pay attention.
I'm the one that got the pre-screener, and then I'm like there with my friends. I'm like, dude, come on. Look.
No,
look,
pay attention.
Watch
pay attention.
Watch.
Yeah.
Hey, shut up.
That's
no,
exactly
look,
it.
Look.
That's what you're doing.
The three men who were.
What did you print this on?
Oh,
Jesus
my,
Christ,
my, yeah,
dude.
My ink's running out.
Kevin's like, I found the documents.
I had to kill an FBI agent.
That's
for
what
these.
It looks like. It looks like you found these documents on the side of a road.
Oh, it needs a bunch of blackout on it, though.
Yeah. No, my
redacted.
Yeah. My printer's running out of ink. But I got everything. It's all good. I got the documents. So we all know the Titanic. There were 2,223 passengers and crew members aboard, and 1,517 of them were killed when it went down.
Lost souls.
When it yes, lost souls. When it hit the iceberg. Now, in this. This theory, though, is that the Titanic did not hit an iceberg. It was sunk on purpose.
By the Germans.
No.
Yeah. The wolf pack.
To kill these individuals because they were standing in the way of the creation of the Federal Reserve.
Well, I thought you said J.P. Morgan was part of starting it.
So, he was. J.P. Morgan was not on the boat. He was supposed to be on this trip, but he
And the people that were against the Federal Reserve were on the Titanic.
They were all on it.
Well, so the,
those
know,
people,
the powers that be said, hey, JP, don't get on the boat.
No. He
He's the one
he's
trying
the
to
one
fucking help start it.
He is the powers that be.
Yes.
Yeah, dude, he was the richest guy, I think,
yeah,
at the time.
He was. And these were the people standing in his
way. You
know,
JP Morgan Chase Bank?
Yeah.
I'm a member.
Okay, there you go.
You're part of it.
You're part of the fucking problem, Tim.
That's made me a
lot of money. JP Morgan decided at the last minute, he wasn't going to go on the maiden voyage of the Titanic. But these three men, who just happened to be the ones standing in the way of the creation of the Federal Reserve, were on the Titanic. And all three of them died. Now, those men...
All of them were influencers,
okay,
Tim.
But I want to know, is what were the purposes of them not wanting to...
Well, they had various reasons. And it's
actually, they didn't like Jews.
It's actually a little complicated.
I can't fault them for that.
So that was the main reason.
They all three of them had their own reasons for it because they all ran different companies. And
right, so
and so
personal gain is why they didn't want it.
Well, that's usually why anybody wants
and
anything.
It would have caused problems for each of their businesses.
Whatever a greater good type
thing.
Not a lot of
so,
greater good.
But these guys were basically big obstacles because they could not go forward.
So is the iceberg.
Without these guys. And so was the iceberg.
That was
so
a big
well, but we don't know if it was an iceberg because if this theory's correct,
it's close enough.
If this theory's correct,
rim shot
now
almost.
Who knows? Now one theory is that it was the iceberg, but the pilot, the people running the ship,
the pilot
were the pilot of the boat of
the
Titanic.
Pilot.
They were
that's
the people that steer the ship.
That's a pilot. That's the correct word for it.
They on purpose.
I don't think that's the correct word.
That's the correct word for the boat.
That
steery
these guys
guy.
Were paid
the turny,
to ram.
Guy.
The turny man.
These guys were paid to sink the vessel on this iceberg. But then there's another theory that
the iceberg was being driven.
Yes. It was actually a submarine.
There was a pilot in the iceberg.
It was a German
iceberg. It was J.P. Morgan driving the iceberg.
Dressed as a penguin. They're like, oh, there's a penguin on it. That's a cute little penguin.
He's adorable.
Penguin have binoculars?
He's getting bigger.
Why does the penguin have a steering wheel? That's fucking weird. Why is there steam coming from that iceberg?
Got a cape on that says J.P.
Yeah, it's just a dude in a tuxedo, but everybody's so dumb. They're all the South Park parents. Like, dude, that's clearly a guy in a suit.
Let's start a movement.
No, that's a penguin.
I like this theory much better.
Yeah. So the three men were Benjamin Guggenheim.
What?
Benjamin Guggenheim.
Guggenheim.
Isidore Strauss and John Jacob Astor.
I know the John Jacob Astor. That's the guy that Astoria. They got a building there in Astoria.
Is that really based on him? Oh, really? Oh, wow. Well, he died.
Yeah, that's his mansion there in Astoria. Astor Mansion.
He's dead, though.
It's been empty a long time.
Yeah. Since at least 1912.
You can tour it. It's pretty cool.
So, by April 1912, all opposition to the Federal Reserve was eliminated. And in December 1913, the Federal Reserve was born. Controlled
a year later
by the elite banking cabal whose ultimate agenda was to enslave humanity. At least,
yes,
based
to
on the
theory. Enslave humanity, as Kevin said.
Enslave humanity.
Enslave. We're going to enslave your senses.
We're going to enslave your sins.
No, sense slave.
Sense slave.
We're enslaving your senses. You can no
you
longer smell
sense
or
offender.
See or hear.
If you smell, see, or hear, you're a sense offender.
Or taste. No more taste for you, fatty.
What?
I'm just attacking
so essentially,
you
it
for
was
no reason.
Wow.
Because you were on your fucking phone.
I was looking at John Jacob Astor. That's cool.
Now remember that the White Star Line was owned by J.P. Morgan.
It would have been better if it was John Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt.
That's my name, too.
So that is one theory.
All of the people on the Titanic were named John Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt.
So there's other theories about this whole idea. So
and we're back.
And we're back. Man,
all right.
Thank you so much,
everybody. Go ahead, Kevin. Get back into this goddamn thing.
Okay, so.
so for anybody that was listening and then was like, what the fuck just happened? We finally ran out of room on a recorder. After a year and almost a half of fucking recording shit.
So almost a full 79 episodes, about halfway through the 79th episode. Actually, a little more than
that. Dude, actually, we're over a year and a half in.
Yeah. We're getting close to
2 years.
Yeah, 2 years, because 100, I think.
Wow, and disappointment. Oh, man.
Yeah. How's things going on that Titanic boat, by the way?
So, okay.
Fuck you, Tim.
Hey, and you know what? We at least we're at a good spot where we got cut off. At, we were starting to move into the other theories about this, because we're done with the J.P. Morgan stuff.
All right.
Now we're moving into the other possibility here about who sank this, was that it could have been the Rothschilds and the Jesuits. Strangely enough, apparently
the people from the
together.
Fucking Spice Planet.
Yeah,
the Jesuit priests.
No, you mean
the Mother Jesuits?
Oh, are you talking about Dune?
Yeah,
the Bene Gesserits.
Bene Gesserits. Yeah. Okay, that's different. Yeah. Sorry about that. Yeah. that was
The Bene Gesserits.
Odd thing to do. The ones with the
and
blue
the Harkonnens
eyes, right?
Well, they can see the future, so they know that this is the right move.
Of course, they're master chess players.
Yeah, well, there's something.
But so the alternative version is that the Rothschild banking family or the Jesuits were the ones that actually arranged for Astor, Strauss, and Guggenheim's deaths on the Titanic. What was that?
It sounded like a guitar string, didn't it?
But it also sounded like a goat or a cow going,
it did kind of sound like an animal.
Yeah, like, meh.
No, I think the cat must have hit the guitar. Hit that low D.
Interesting.
You love it when the cat hits your low D.
So, right. Now that's the other.
Well done.
So that's another one of the theories. Now, the Rothschilds have been
Tim
connected to all sorts of different conspiracies. I mean, we've all heard of the Rothschilds.
I am.
Apparently, they're the big bad guys. People think they're in the Illuminati and whatever else.
Tim is the most ignorant person I've ever met.
Well, that's what makes it interesting. There's other people that are dumber than me.
It's not many.
Not many.
I can think of a handful.
You could bring up something. You'd be like, hey, have you heard of a vacuum? And he's like, what is that?
No, I know what a vacuum is. That's a chamber that takes away all the air. And it makes it so there's no... a feather will fall as fast as a lead ball. It would
have been funny if you were like...
I'd say that's a vacuum.
That's the
chamber.
Thing that I put on my penis.
Oh, no, that's a penis pump.
It's also a type of vacuum.
No, because you're taking out the
air.
It makes it smaller.
No, you're...
No, the one I use, it you pump air into it.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's a reverse penis pump.
Yeah.
It's so Tim can try to fuck himself?
Yeah.
That's pushing your own dick inside yourself?
It makes it an innie.
Oh, there you go.
It's kind of... There's a... I don't want to say there's pleasure involved with it, but there's something involved with it.
It's called shame, Tim. It's definitely shame.
Just when I go outside afterwards, blasts of hot air. That's the shame part about it.
Isn't that... wait, for sidebar. isn't that the fucked up thing about coming, though? Like, you come and then you're just like... oh, man, I was supposed to do things today.
things have changed.
What? My view of the world is so different. It's kind of like in those movies where it goes from, like, black and white to color.
That's what,
like,
they
just
call,
out of nowhere.
That's what they call post-nut clarity.
Yes, it's a real thing.
That
yes,
does it exist. Is. It is. Yeah, I get it.
Like, afterwards, you're like, oh, God.
Oh, shit, I forgot I was showering. I'm supposed to be cleaning up, not making it dirtier.
Although it's a shower, it's fine.
I think
don't do it in the bath.
He was talking about that on one of his episodes, real quick too. Like how he was on tour with Jimmy Kimmel, and the hotel they were staying at, the shower would clog up. The drain would clog up and fill with water.
Fuck that!
And Carolla says he's in there taking a shower, and Kimmel says through the door, "Hey, I had myself in the shower there earlier, so have fun with that little iceberg." And Carolla says, "I have never felt so dirty and so clean in my entire life."
That's a guy that's changed over the years.
You're wading
Kimmel?
Around in water.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Kimmel, now he's like a fucking
crybaby
propagandist, too.
Well, again, it's following the money.
Yeah.
That's what I think it is.
That's it.
Well, yeah. I mean, if you were offered what he's offered, I'm sure you'd probably do the same thing. Exactly. Tim would be like, "Yeah, no, I'll dress as a lady."
Did it for the show. That's
be
not
a mouthpiece for the establishment.
So the Rothschilds are these rich sons of bitches.
Yes, very, very, very rich. Old money. Goes back a long way.
They might be considered the richest family in the world outside of like any of the...
not the Waltons or whatever? Or
the Walmart family? No, no, not even close.
Oh, wow.
Not even close. They're banking.
Yeah, these are...
They're the people that lend money to Walmart.
It's the Iron Bank.
Yes.
Basically. That's,
but no, the only people that would be maybe considered more wealthy than them would be like
Christians.
Saudi Arabian the family.
Stuff.
No, not the princes, because the princes, they have a portion of the money.
Right, right.
The family itself, like if you're going by families, I think the Saudi Arabian royal families and shit.
That's that oil.
But there's
money.
Like 4,000 princes in there. Well, yeah, it's crazy. They're like, we're all rich or something. Those guys
fucking like will literally leave their Ferraris at the side of the road.
You should see how decked out their camels are.
I believe it.
Yeah, they're fucking rich.
Cup holders on a camel.
Yeah.
In a camel, they just drill holes in them.
Like
it's steel mounted.
They store water in the back.
It's
right?
born this way. That's how they do it now. They've gotten into genetics.
They don't wear camel backs. They just drill into the camel back. They're like, that's where the water is.
Yep.
They've genetically altered camels to have cup holders.
Yeah, no, to actually produce Kool-Aid.
Gold hymns and shit like that. Yeah, I believe it.
It's Hawaiian. This one's Hawaiian punch.
Yeah. It would be fucking weird. All right, so back to the story, Kevin.
Okay.
Jesus.
I said Rothschilds earlier. We're
now,
not doing
okay,
it, dude.
Them,
come on. Jesus
now,
Christ.
Okay, so now
the
we're
sidebars
move on.
Are fun.
So now we're going to move on to another theory that the Titanic never actually sank.
It's in space. It was in Fast and Furious 9.
It never existed.
So what this theory posits is that...
The Olympic.
Someone switched the Titanic with another White Star Line.
You want to know
which
why?
Happened to be the Olympic.
Do you know
which
why?
Which looked exactly the
but
same
do you know
as
why?
The Titanic. Well, what do you think?
Okay, so the reason is...
going to get something here.
Well, it may be the same thing. It may not be, because I've heard multiple theories on it. Okay. But the Olympic did actually have this happen in port... It ended up crashing into another ship.
Yep.
And tore open the side, and it would cost too much to fix it that they just kind of patched it up, wrote Titanic on it, and like, fuck it. Let's see what happens.
Yep, and that's what I... That's
okay, see, I heard multiple. That's why I was seeing...
The Olympic was damaged while sailing from Southampton, England to New York on September 1911, and it had to return to Wolff's shipping yard in Belfast for repairs. The company repaired the Olympic, and it sailed to New York and back. It returned to Belfast for more repairs in March 1912, a few weeks before the Titanic set sail. And that's where the switch happened.
That's where they believe, yes.
They believe the switch happened, yeah. So the theory
claims...
What
was the point of that, though? Why would they do that?
Because the Olympic's already destroyed.
Right.
And they could get the insurance money if it's...
Oh, insurance scam.
Yes.
Okay, that makes sense. Okay.
But the only problem with that theory, though, is... The cost of the Titanic, right? So if I don't know what the cost of the Olympic was, but the cost of the Titanic
was around
$5 million to build, and the insurance was only for about $3
million. Yeah, so
it would be taking a loss.
It was probably similar in cost.
But if the Olympic was cheaper, which it might have been, because they were different ships, even though they had
even though they had the same design.
Yes.
Yeah.
They were different ships, so it's possible that it did cost less, and or that because the repairs were so expensive, why not sink it and get the insurance? It's more than what the
repairs would be.
Could have been made from
it's less than what the repairs would cost.
Yeah, it's like a
could have
a
been
recall.
Made from different yeah. materials yeah. than one of the other
so
ones.
So that would make sense in that theory. Mm-hmm.
So that actually
in
is
our dumb brains.
What I was going to get to is
I put it together.
Basically, that the theory claims that some person or people found the Olympic too severely damaged to be profitable, and so at some point switched it out with the Titanic to purposefully ditch the damaged ship, reap the insurance money, and it seems kill a bunch of people in the process.
Oh,
that
there's several birds
killed.
With one stone.
That's right.
Really?
Two birds, one
all
stone.
The birds.
Baby.
That's why the Rothschilds are rich, man. That's how they're the rich.
Dude,
and
they're
good
not
them.
The Rothschilds.
And
they're the
hole,
fucking Targaryens.
And the hole, which Shane actually, already described, was that the insurance wasn't enough to actually
no, be
cover.
The other ones.
Yeah.
The insurance Lannisters. Wasn't the enough to cover the Olympics loss.
So the Rothschilds are the Lannisters.
Yep.
Yes.
I got that.
Who's the Targaryens in this?
Probably.
Where are the dragons?
The Jesuits.
Well, no, the people on the... No, I think the Targaryens are the people that were on the Titanic.
Yeah, because instead of burning the entire city, they just sink it.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
And of course,
I like
you know,
it.
No one got knifed,
so,
that we know of.
George back. Martin is a fucking thief. He yeah. stole it from the Titanic.
That's how he yeah. got his That's how he got his
motherfucker.
Whole plot.
I knew it.
He's a real son of a bitch.
I ain't no goddamn son of a bitch.
I really wish they would have.
You better
that
think
better.
About it, baby.
God damn it! I was about to say that. So, fucking, that's my favorite song.
I love that
Where
song.
Eagles Dare.
I love Where Eagles Dare.
You like that song?
It's a fucking great song.
I'm not a fan.
You don't like Misfits?
No.
I fucking love them.
That's why you'd like Ice Nine Kills.
I love Ice Nine Kills. I told you. To a bunch of it now.
They're
I love
same,
them.
Same, similar. Idea behind them, not genre, but
no,
idea.
But yeah, yeah, absolutely.
One does B movies, one does horror movies.
Uh-huh. I fucking love it, man. They do great music.
Yeah, they're fucking great.
And their videos are fucking
We
hilarious.
Should talk about this for a while because yeah. of the Red Dead Redemption thing. So Tim can just sit there. I'm going to be
but
in
hey,
my food.
Okay, so we got
I'm
one more.
I'm
going to
make text.
So we've got one more theory, and this is the one that's even crazy, kind of crazier than the other.
Please
conspiracy
be aliens,
theories.
Please.
It's not aliens.
Is it as crazy as you just doing a Hitler salute?
Yes.
Is it like, is it like Pacific Rim robots then? Can we have that?
No robots.
God damn it.
This one actually is more of a... I'd say it's more Indiana Jones-ish.
So it's got aliens.
What was that? Who did that? That was okay.
That
was
not
Kevin.
Me.
That was Kevin.
That might have been me.
The next theory Jones-ish. Is actually a Pacific Rim job.
That's a Chewbacca.
Yeah. He's actually got it down pretty well.
So,
that's pretty good.
Usually, so what he does is he puts cum in the back of his throat and bubbles it.
It's always
it's
there.
The
yeah,
only
it's
way.
Always there.
It's the only way.
He can never swallow.
He has to.
He saves. I need another.
And his mouth is
you know
so wet that
no,
it keeps
no,
it alive.
You know how chipmunks have little pockets of air? Mine are in my throat.
Oh, my God. Oh, God.
He doesn't have tonsils. He has pockets.
I store it for winter.
Ugh. It's so, to get him through the, protein.
Yeah.
There you go.
You got to survive the cold somehow. So, a mummy's curse sank the Titanic.
Oh, I've heard that one too. There is a lot of there's a lot of holes with this one though.
There are, but still, okay.
Due to the fact that it wasn't even it's been in Britain the entire time.
Well, no, the mummy has yes.
No,
now,
actually, the sarcophagus has.
Right, but there
the
is.
Can we get to the fucking story and stop?
I want to attack it immediately.
Jesus so Christ, one of the,
let's
so,
set it up first before you knock it down.
One
golly.
Of the passengers
tried that earlier and then he yelled at me.
So one of the passengers who went down with the Titanic was William.
Was a mummy.
Stead.
Oh, sorry.
Not the mummy. It was actually in the British Museum. He was a British editor who subscribed to early 20th century spiritualism, and he'd spent the past several years claiming a cursed mummy was causing mysterious destruction and disaster in London.
It's always a cursed mummy.
As with other myths, you know.
I thought it was Jack the Ripper, but...
Yeah, that was earlier than that. That
Jack the Ripper was earlier.
Late
1800s. That was
1800s. Different
era.
Yeah, way to go, dummy.
Or,
so basically...
Oh, was it a cow? It was a cow at one point, too, wasn't it?
A cow?
That burned London down?
Oh, yeah, there was something weird, like it burnt the bridge down or something like that. Cow London Bridge has been through a lot of shit. It's in Arizona.
So it is well known that this guy was actually, he was on the Titanic.
Brick by brick.
Where it belongs.
And he was on the Titanic, and
he was
telling people about the
these
mummy
war.
Curses and Egyptian curses. And it's actually been recorded that he was there telling people this, because people that survived talked about him. Talking about this stuff.
Was
yeah,
he at the
people
dinner
talked
table
about
with Jack?
Jesus, too.
Was sure,
that,
I'm sure
that
they
the
did.
Guy?
I mean, that's all real, too.
Was he at the dinner table with Jack that was making fun of him the whole fucking
Jack
time?
Jack actually didn't exist.
Oh.
That guy was made up for the movie.
Dude, there was plenty of room on that goddamn fucking door.
We all know that.
There was plenty of fucking room on the door.
Such fucking nonsense.
It made no sense. That door was fucking huge.
Needed to be comfortable, that's all.
She's like, Jack, three people on that fucking door.
Yeah, and the thing is, this is back when people weren't 800 pounds.
No, they were a lot smaller back then.
Yeah.
It's true. It's true.
So, I mean, you could
like half our size.
Yeah. They're like, probably it's a screen door you could float on it. Jesus Christ.
And you know the girl probably weighed even less.
Yeah, like, she was like 110.
Yeah, yeah. If that.
Yeah.
If that.
And that was half of it was the dress.
Yeah, those corsets and shit. They like squeezed the
that's
life
the thing.
Out of them.
Imagine trying to fuck back then. Oh, like you're like really passionate.
It
takes
half an hour to get through the dress,
and then the stink that you get to.
It would just waft.
The amount of clothing you're wearing in humid, fucking hot air. God.
And they don't shave, so it's just a bush.
It'd be like banging an Iraqi in the desert, taking off all the clothing and layers and stuff.
You've really thought about this.
I've just been told that by soldiers that like when they would have to strip search them, they have to go through layer and layer, and every layer they went through.
I thought you were talking to soldiers about a lot of rape or something. What the fuck, dude?
I was told by guys that they could literally smell them coming on the wind.
Oh my god.
Who told you this? Don't say the name.
No, I've actually heard this from several people.
Okay, I was going to ask if it was the same person I know.
I have heard it from him, too.
Okay, because it's hard to tell with him at times.
Yes, I know.
He did tell us about going to South America and shooting a bunch of people or something
like
that.
That's true.
That never happened.
I know, right? What the fuck? No, but I've actually heard this from other guys.
That's why I was asking.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't want him in his sweater to get mad at us.
He could have heard this from someone that was...
Maybe we can get back to the whole sweater sticky vagina.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Tim... So in the 1800s,
keep going because I'm almost there.
Here, can you put on the sexy music again?
There it is.
All right. So they used to wear a lot of clothing, and they would sit and sweat all day, right in the crotch area, Tim.
Keep going.
And you'd have to pull down. You'd have to undo a corset,
woo!
And then a fucking like an undershirt,
woo!
And then like some
knickers.
Knickers.
Yep.
Four sets of bras.
Make sure it's a hard K.
And then for some reason. Metal shit that was around their bodies
to
make their
belt.
Ass look like way bigger than it was.
Yeah, the bustle.
The chastity belt.
No, not chastity belt.
It's called a
bustle. You know the chicks that would have the dress made their ass look like it was 8 feet long?
Oh, yeah, yes, yes.
Kate, you're not wearing a bustle. Mm-hmm. How lewd.
See, there you go. Tim knows
it
something finally.
Gave them
finally.
A hump like
Tombstone.
A camel on the back.
Anyway, back to the story.
On board the Titanic, Stead happily repeated his tale of the mummy's curse to other passengers. And after the ship sank, a survivor recounted Stead's story to the New York World newspaper. And
it was actually also in the New York Times, I believe.
It probably was, yeah, because this went around.
It was in a bunch of newspapers.
The Washington Post also ran a headline about ghost. This is the headline, Ghost of the Titanic, Vengeance of Hoodoo Mummy Followed Man Who Wrote Its History. So... I don't know what the hoodoo thing
is. That fell fucking flat. That fell fucking flat on his fucking face.
I don't know what the fuck a hoodoo is, but
this reminds me of like,
and that's it.
You go to somebody's house for the 4th of July thing. They light off the fucking box, and you're like, yes, this is gonna be amazing. Woo!
Pop didn't even pop. It just
and it just floated to the ground.
Like, all right, conspiracy corner.
So essentially, there was a lot of people that linked this mummy's curse to the Titanic sinking, because not everybody on the Titanic knew it hit an iceberg, because not all of them saw
it. The ship was gigantic.
Right.
You just hear the ship sinking, you're like freaking the fuck out.
Yeah.
I'm sure there are people like, oh yeah, right, sure, it's sinking. Oh, good.
Well,
they
true.
Said it's unsinkable.
Well, I believe that.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
See? I'm back to my scotch, please.
Well, and that's the thing. That's exactly it.
Give me a second.
There's a lot of people that's why there was a lot of people
I'm not
that fucking
pay my
didn't,
taxes,
even,
see?
Didn't even try to escape
Time
until
shoes, boy.
It was almost too late, you know?
Shiny shoes.
So anyway,
see?
This is gonna be our longest episode.
Yeah. So they say that people link the mummy's curse to Egyptian artifacts that this survivor Margaret Brown actually took with her on the Titanic, and she was supposed to deliver them to a museum in Denver, and.
It sounds like the plot to Ghost Ship. Are we talking about the plot to Ghost Ship?
I remember that movie.
But it was gold?
Yeah, it was gold, wasn't it, in that movie? Yeah.
Devil needed to collect his souls.
Yeah, well, in this, they didn't say what kind of artifacts they were, Keith but Urban apparently this woman may have taken them. She was supposed to be bringing them to this museum.
You know what I've been craving to watch lately is Hellraiser.
I fucking love those movies.
Never seen it.
What?
I've never seen it.
Watch it.
Rated R.
Oh, yeah.
You're a grown man.
Don't watch it.
Rated R. Nobody, 80s movies, dude. I've never seen them.
Watch them now.
Yeah. Well, see, I only saw it the first time when I went over to my friend's house, and his dad had a man cave down in the fucking basement.
As most men did back in that day.
It was fucking awesome.
A fridge full of beer that you'd sneak one every
now
and then.
Dude, this house looked so tiny from the top of it.
Yeah.
Then you go downstairs,
giant
and
basement.
It's one full basement, the exact
bear
size
rug
of the house.
On the wall and shit like that. Or
fucking awesome.
And shit.
So we watched the very first one, and I was like, well, I've never seen anything like this.
Yeah.
Why are your clothes off?
I didn't even question it, Tim. Didn't even question it. I was like,
movie,
it is pretty warm down here.
After that movie, you wouldn't question a lot of things. No, that movie was like a total. When it came out, it blew people's minds because there's
second
nothing
one,
like that.
I like the second one
a
lot.
I love the second
and the
one
reason
as well.
Being is because of the Cenobites. The rest of the Cenobites start coming through
yes,
in that one.
Yes.
That's why I liked it.
And you see more, you get to see their world.
Well, the third one's wonky.
Third one's not as good. That's
it's,
when they start
it's not,
downhill.
But it's wonky. I like it still.
I do.
But
I
it's
do.
Wonky as fuck because you got somebody throwing CDs and killing people.
Yeah, the CD head guy, yeah. And then there's the dude with the camera in his fucking head.
What the fuck is that? But it's wonky. Like, it's one of those where it's like, all right, we're getting into the absurdity level, but let's have fun.
And then the fourth one.
Yes, pretend to sleep, Tim. Or are you pretending that's a dick on your face? Dick on your face. Okay,
yeah, and the fourth
I
one, they go to space.
Okay, that
and they tell the story of,
dumb.
And it goes flashback, tells the story about how the box was made and everything.
So how was this box made?
With a vagina.
It was.
Oh,
made.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah,
that's a sex joke. I get it, Tib.
Iron bangles and hammers. So, anyway. So there
just
was
end the fucking show. So, push a button, please.
So there are other. So there are other. Other. You know, other parts of the story.
How many others?
Play them out, Sam.
So there's other versions of the story that the mummy was actually on board, but now we know for sure that it never was. It was in the British Museum. Are we done?
Yes, I hope so. Jesus.
All right. That's the corner.
Tim just kept saying,
go to Coffee Brand Coffee. Use coupon code GPS1 for 5% off your purchase.
Velvet-Alley.com. Check out their toys. That transmission just got one in. It's fucking awesome.
And go fuck yourself. All right, goodbye, everybody.
Like, subscribe.